What's up, everybody? My name is Lehua, and welcome to the Superfina channel. I am Eho, a variety content creator, host of podcasts across worlds, and I stream on twitch.tv/Lehua Superfina. Today, we are reviewing Tsukimichi. And if you like anime reviews, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell, so you can be notified on the next upload. And if you would like to support the channel, we got Patreon and channel membership. Link to those are below. We are reviewing Tsukimichi episode 4. And this was the episode I was waiting for. I used 4. Anyways, this was an episode that had fight scenes, special effects, had great animation. And the reason why I was wanting this is because I know this anime has great effects, animation, and such. And they gave me pieces of it. Every episode, there's like one scene with one good, great, phenomenal animation. I'm the type, if you allow me to have a bite, I want the whole thing. And this episode didn't only give me one good scene, it gave me multiple good scenes. So I was like very happy about this. Now in this episode review, I'm going to do something a little different. I'm going to do a mini recap of the episode, and then I'm going to talk about things that piqued my interest. This episode continued from episode 3, where Makoto and Mio, they encountered a little girl. Her name turns out to be Rina, and her sister got abducted. Her sister got involved with shady people, and then they take Rina in, and at the same time, Tomoe was taking care of intruders who were going after their wagon filled with merchandise. And then they were able to get one person from the intruders. And Tomoe, she went through their memories. And it turned out those intruders were in cahoots with the people who abducted Renan's sister. Then they go to save Renan's sister, whose name is Toa. And then it turns out the shady people were run by the top adventurer in this town. And in the same building, there are other people like Toa. I don't know what their circumstances were. I don't know why they got there. But the shady people, they locked them up. And while Tomoe and Mio were fighting with the bad guys, they inadvertently destroyed the building. And then somehow, Mio and Tomoe, they were getting competitive. Yes, competitive. They're getting really competitive, showing like who's more powerful, who's more useful to Makoto, and they end up destroying the town. And that was the end of the episode. Some of the things I wanted to point out were the phenomenal special effects things. So there was a part where Tomoe apprehended the intruders, the first part, or in the beginning of the episode. Ooh, boy, they had great animation. They had like blue effects for Tomoe's attacks. They had scenes where Tomoe's weapon was making contact with her enemy's weapons, and it had like a big ching look. And the way Tomoe was moving was so fluid. It was looking so good. And this one part where she just makes a slice motion, and at first you see the enemies. They're like kind of paralyzed. And then all of a sudden you see like splurts of blood, and then their body was actually cut in half and it just slid off, and then spurts of blood. I'm like, oh my gosh, this looks so good. Yes. And there is humor in it too, where Tomoe is like, oh, I was actually holding back. I didn't mean for that to happen. Another good special effects part was when they went to save Toa. Boy, this is where we see Mio's powers in this human form. Yo, her aura, whatever it is, was making like a purplish black thing going on. It looks so good. It looks like it disintegrates materials. It totally reminded me of that time I got reincarnated as a slime, where Rimuru uses a power and it has that purple black thing going on. I want to say it was one of his new skills that he got right before he became a demon lord, or was it right after? I'm gonna have to rewatch the episode. Oh, a reason to rewatch the episode. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is I was getting those chills, those vibes. I was like, yes, get me excited for this anime. Yes. And then we got to see Tomoe's skills. She had like a red one where she was like kind of powering up and then she punched a barrier and it exploded. And then she had another one with her blue aura and she was fighting and such. And then there's this part where one of the bad guys, she like put her hand on them. And then she did that memory thing where she made an illusion. This guy, I don't know why it made it like this, but he was surrounded by snakes and the snakes were like going in his mouth, and at first it was one, then it was multiple, then the scene changed and it showed him in a euphoric look face, and I questioned it. I was like, was he afraid of that? Does he look like that because his mind snapped, or did he actually like it? So that was another funny thing. This scene was really good. We had Tomoe fighting all kinds of styles, throwing people around, and we had Neo using her powers, going melt, disintegrate. And then the part where I said in the recap where they got competitive and they were just showing off each other's powers, destroying this town and all the effects. Yes! The next thing I want to talk about is the humor. Humor is on point again. In the beginning of the episode where Rinnan encounters Makoto and Mio. So Makoto had Mio talk to Rinnan because he can't really talk verbally. And so when Mio talks to Rinnan, she kind of intimidates her. Actually, she scares her. And she didn't mean to do it because she was upset that Rinnan interrupted their time together. And Makoto scolded her for that. He's like, how can you be like that with her? And Mio was just being honest. She's like, well, she interrupted us. But the thing was, Makoto and Mio together, it was staged. It was staged to like attract hooligans and such. And then Makoto like just pinches her nose. And it was cute, it was funny, but it also shows how comfortable he is with Mio. Another funny part was after Tomoe got one of the intruders, before they filtered through their brain for memories and such, Makoto took off that person's gear, weapons, and all of a sudden the boobs like popped out. Not like nudity kind, it just like popped out under like, I guess it was a... like a sports bra, I think. So the boobs don't restrict the body because, okay, if people don't know this, if someone is heavy up there, it can move around if you don't restrict it. So I think that's what the person had like a type of sports bra, and after it came off, it went boing. And Makoto was so embarrassed by it, he turns to Tomoe and is like, you're supposed to check what their gender is so I can be prepared. And Tomoe is like, oh, I didn't want to check because I didn't want to be seen like a pervert. And I think that's really funny because Tomoe is a girl. And it's like, I don't think it would be seen as you as a pervert because you're also a female. But maybe because of our times now, I'm not too sure if this was in the manga or the novel, but in today's time, yes, another female doing that to a fellow female, it could seem kind of perverted and such. We are in that time where it's like you don't have to be opposite genders. The next funny part for me was when they encountered the boss bad guy. I don't remember his name. I don't care to remember his name. I don't think I need to remember his name, but besides that, when he was talking about how there's like a monster that came by the town and there's a bounty on him and he wanted to bring in Tomoe and Mio to help apprehend the monster and get the rewards and such, Tomoe knew that they were talking about Makoto and she was like laughing because Makoto was like so distraught that he was seen as a monster, and she's like, ho ho ho, I will pass this on. And then the bad guy, he's talking about how they can totally get the monster. They'll be successful with Tomoe and Mia. And then Mia's like, oh, I don't dare to fight him. Oh, no. That was funny because they knew who that monster was. And it was their master. And he's in town. So it's like really funny how they're viewing this person, this thing, as like an evil, a monster and such, when he's just being super normal in town. Now we're gonna talk about the parts that piqued my interest. The first one is when Makoto saw a drawing of Toa, and he noted that she looked like one of his friends back in the previous world. And he saw Toa, and he confirmed that they do look similar. And I'm just wondering if Makoto's gonna meet more people like that. Someone who's going to look like another person from the other world he came from? Or is it just Toa? And I'm wondering why Toa? I don't know if this is going to be significant because it could be just that one character. But they did have a section for Toa talking about how her family was renowned adventurers and they lost a family treasure. So I'm wondering if that's going to happen or be brought up again later on in the series. And maybe that's why she looks so special, why she looks like someone that Makoto is familiar with. The other part I want to talk about is Makoto's mood. When Mia came in after Makoto learned about Toa and such, he had such a dark disposition. It was sort of like he's really serious or he's ready to kill someone. It was very similar to when he first fought Mia and he kind of snapped and went on full power and such. I'm wondering if this is going to happen again whenever he gets serious about something or whenever he wants to unleash more power. And I'm wondering if this is going to like change things. Like, I'm not too sure what it's going to change, but I'm thinking it's going to change something big in this world. I'm not too sure, but I'm anticipating stuff. I have high hopes just from seeing that dark mood. And that was my review of Tsukimichi episode 4. What did you think about that episode? If you have things you want to point out or talk about from the episode, let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't seen this episode, what's your impression from this video? If you want to talk outside of YouTube, there's a Discord. Link is in the description. I also stream on twitch.tv/lihuosuperfina. People who watch these videos do like to stop by the stream. Outside of YouTube and Twitch, I host podcasts across worlds where we talk about anime, manga, and other things we're interested in. If you like podcasts like that, link to the podcast is in the description. I'm available on all platforms. Other than that, my name is Leihua, and this is the Superfina channel reviewing Tsukimichi episode 4. Hope you guys like this video, and I'll see you on the next one. Laters! Huge thanks to my Patreons and channel members for making this video possible. If you also want to be part of the Superfina party, you can click over here or become a channel member. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the next video. And I do stream live on Twitch every Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. Hope to see you guys there, and I will see you on the next video. Fist bump!